The hell is that? And a lot of bones. Oh, hello. Zombie? Or something worse. Skeletons. Oh, Nelvin. Wait, too far away. He's got a regular dagger. Some sling stones. He's gonna miss, of course. Might as well use them. Oh, but you know what I forgot to look at? Does he know any spells? Does he have any spells on him? Right? I forgot to do that. Magical projectile. Sleep. Mud Sling, Rockfall, and Wind Devil. Interesting. I want to see if there's any other spells he's capable of using that are, you know, he needs to memorize. Alright, well, I'm just gonna have him throw rocks for now. Edgel will just wait for the other skeleton to come up. Irritate spell. Huh. Are any of us irritated? I am. We might have something to fix that? We have this thing, but none of us can use it. Mass healing. Well, this one is the destroy undead or something. The spell undead. But only usable by a healer or... Oh, anyone can use that, actually. So if they get a little too crazy, we'll just use this and dispel them. As for now, I wonder if we have anything that can... Get rid of irritate. Remove panic. Not that qualifies. Revitalizing flask. Restore stamina. That's not it. Speed potion. I might not be able to attack while I'm irritated. He doesn't have anything like that. Well, this guy's just gonna stay over here. We gotta get rid of this guy. Alright, never mind. Am I still attacking? Selena, Nelvin, Edgel, Citrine. So I'm not sure what that means. That I'm irritated. Maybe I have a minus to my attack or something. Maybe I can't cast spells or something like that, but I can attack normally. I wonder if the who can use a buckler? Adventure, warrior, paladin, thief, ranger. A thief can use a buckler. But she uses bow and arrow. Never mind then. I don't think the buckler sell for that much at all. The swords, I think it will sell for like 102 or something. Interesting, all this stuff. Wait, no. So am I still irritated? Probably. No, okay. It's gone. Just last for the battle, okay. I'm used to things lasting completely forever, like an amber star. Nelvin says, the angled cross disturbs me. We should straighten it again. Oh, that one? The cross can be straightened without too much effort. When it is vertical, again, you hear a slight click. I think we're straightening the one behind this one. That one, yeah, just moved. Is that good? I mean, did that accomplish anything? What about this on the wall? Maybe we're putting the souls at rest by doing that. I'm stuck in the crosses there. Is that a button? No. Kinda look like it might be a button next to this. I'm glad I wasn't irritated. I didn't want to run all the way back to, Spannenberg? To get the effect removed. There's all these skulls and things. So this is how we'd have a crypt full of skulls. I think that's the door we came through. Any other crosses that we want to straighten? Looking for a ring. Hopefully it's not too hard to find. It might be on the leader of the undead or something like that. Like, might have grabbed it and put it on his bony finger. Alright, so that room is done. Interesting. Looks like it was like had wood over it, right? Which has been clawed away by rats, perhaps. Any more monsters? Another... We want to fix this one? Is that what you would like to do, Nelvin? It's straightened. Oh, monsters! Hi! More skeletons. Oh, he's moving in now. Yeah, never mind then. Trying to anticipate these things' moves. Thank you. Selena actually did 2 points of damage there. Well, that battle was a lot easier. Was another door. I didn't even see this door, and that's where we came through. So pretty much identical to the other room. This is our cemetery music here. So we straighten the crosses here, and I think where we are already over here. Okay, we've done that there as well. Okay. Dunna dunna dunna. And then. Unless it's the way out. Nope. Oops. You can discern a round disc in the floor. Really? Is that a trap? Should I try to circumvent this? Disc there. Maybe it opens that door. Or maybe it's a trap. I don't know. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. I'm hitting this, and it's turning me all the way around, I think. Oh, is the disc turning me? The disc is turning me. It flipped me around. I thought that was me messing something up. Through. There's a button on the wall. And there's a button on that wall. Hmm. I'm bring out the room and I'll look at that button. Oop. Don't want to go through yet. Interesting. Interesting layout, I'm saying. We might be on to episode 47. Pressed it. press that. Now what happens? I have no idea. Maybe the door would be locked otherwise. Is this still depressed? Yeah, it looks like. Hello? Undead thingies? Maybe I have to depress a certain button or hit them in a certain order. Oh, there's a spinner. Wow, it really spun me. You spin me right around, maybe right around. Well, that's a door there, but yeah, we want to be to the opposite side to advance, I'm guessing. I wonder if there's a secret wall or illusory wall, you know, fancy wall. Spinning me. Round disc. Yeah. Damn, really can't go anywhere in there. Have to go around this way. But there's gotta be something with those buttons then. Maybe only one needs to be depressed. Maybe we should take medication for that. Oh, I can't unpress it. I see. Well, that's okay. Well, it's apparently a dead end here, unless there's illusory walls here, or unless I'm supposed to mess with one of these things in the middle. Wait. Oh! Pressing the buttons in here I guess each one revealed another door to that way. Cool that it shows up on the map, even though I haven't gone back there yet. Okay. Now I just gotta figure out which way I'm heading. I think this is the dead end. Yeah. I think this is the way I want. Yeah, alright. So I can go either way. It's switching me around. But I think I'm facing one of the side doors. I mean, I don't care which one I go through, as long as I go through one of them. Oh, it's just switch. I'm back out to the beginning, aren't I? Yep. I need to hug the wall. There's a grave. Headstones here. Interesting. And chains. Nelvin is thinking aloud. The symmetry of the gravestones is curious, as if it had a special meaning. Let's look around a little. Perhaps we will find something. We could start at the center. The center? Well, is there... Oh, there is. That one's a different one. Alright, looking around a little. But, oh, there's a monster near. Oh, hello. I did not realize this was a... I thought it was a small room. Zombies! Poison spell. Mm. Are we poisoned? If we are, I'll cure it afterwards. As far as I know, it doesn't have any effect in combat, so once you're out, you'll take damage over time. Toast now, mister. Okay, so Treen and Nelvin poisoned. Arrows, okay. Selena. I could sell these for 100 each. Oh wait, nope. We have been cured of the poisons. Alright, well we want to look at the tombs before we go on. As Selena touches the gravestone, you hear a gentle ringing. I do? Is that a dinner bell for undead things? Huh. What about back to the original tombstone? He said start with the center one. Nothing. I don't seem to be able to do anything with the other. Have anything else to say about these tombstones? Probably not. No. All of a sudden, you have no idea what I'm talking about. Isn't that funny? Alright, well, we hear a gentle ringing with that. I don't know what that accomplished. Hopefully something good for us, and not bad. What's this? Nelvin says, I do not have a good feeling about these coffins. We should leave them in peace. Should we? What if we don't? Citrine opens the coffin and a thick cloud of dust swirls towards him. The coffin only contains a few bones. Him? Citrine is not a him. Dust. Does that affect me in any way? No? Okay. Bones. You can't walk past it. So look at this and then continue on. Is that a window? Interesting. Why would there be a window in a tomb, like a crypt? There's more of these tombstones. Look at all of them. Gentle ringing. What does it all mean? Nelvin looks excitedly at you and says, something is wrong with the wall here to the north. The north. Okay, so it's to the side of us. Is it a fake wall? We got through here. Oh! And we still have the other coffin to look at. Right before we do this. You don't have a key for this one. And Selena's only half good at figuring out traps. She discovers a trap. You hear a strange sound. I never liked the strange sounds. Okay, disarming a trap. Unable to pick the lock. Opened. Okay. I've got another holy horn. Look at all this stuff. Whoa. Healing potion 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 cure poison flasks. A scroll of holy word. 5 scrolls of destroy undead. That's awesome. Alright. Now we have a lot of healing potions. We haven't needed any for quite a while. Yeah, you take some poison. Cure poisons. Alright, no ring though. Did not find the ring. Nelvin, his search is zero, yet he finds this hidden wall. Look at that. Looks like an upside down cross. Still, this whole area, do that door to discover. So maybe the ring's there. Back through. Okay, another tombstone. I mean, crypt. So I keep saving because he warned us not to open these. So I'm being very cautious. Of course, if some monster pops out and we can fight it, that's experience. So. Just as Selena wants to lift the coffin lid, it is pushed up from inside. A being straight out of a nightmare climbs out of the coffin and attacks you. Straight out of a nightmare. It's a ghoul! Awesome!